Hey guys, it's Sarah from She's Crafty and She Knows It, and I wanted to show you this table. I actually found this table in my neighbor's trash, and I asked, of course, if I could have it, and they said, of course, it was out there for the trash anyways, so I grabbed it up. There's nothing better than free furniture, in my opinion. So what I did was I did a spray paint on the bottom. I ended up leaving the top the same that it was, and it ended up super cute. So I'm going to show you how I did it real quick for those of you that have been asking me how to make over wood furniture. So here we go. So first I just taped off the top so that it wouldn't get any paint on it. So easy peasy, 1, 2, 3 and done. And for those of you wondering, I did use painter's tape to tape the top off. So that way when I peel the tape off at the end, it will not pull any of the paint with it and it'll come up easily. So that makes an easy step. So then I just went ahead and did normal spray paint. So I had spray paint that I was going to use and I just shook it up. You can use any spray paint that you want. You could use regular paint if you want. I just find that spray paint is so easy and it goes so quickly. So of course you start by shaking the paint can, getting it ready to go, and then I just painted the entire thing. Now to be quite honest, this was the paint that I had used for my daughter's headboards that I'd recently redone. And so I didn't have a full can left. So I just sprayed it until my can was empty. So there are a couple spots that are a little bit bare. You'll notice in the video, and that's okay. I knew that I was gonna go back and do a sanding, a wet sand actually. And so I wasn't really too concerned with some spots being a little bit lighter than other spots. But if you're more particular, go ahead, do a full coat. You could even do a full coat, let it dry, and do a second coat. But on this particular table, I tried something new for the first time. In the past, I've always spray painted, let it dry according to the can, which is like, it varies, but you know, a couple hours, you wait between coats, you wait for it to dry before you sand it. With this one, I was impatient and I had read things about doing a wet sand, and so I gave it a try. And guys, I'm telling you, from the time I started taping it, to painting it, to sanding it, it was less than 30 minutes. Honestly, probably closer to 15 minutes, and I was completely done. And it turned out perfect, and all it had to do then was dry. So I just did the painting, sprayed it everywhere, like I said, until I was out of paint. Then I went and got my sandpaper and just started sanding the table immediately. So the paint at this point is completely wet and I'm sanding it. So I ended up using the 80 grit sandpaper, for those of you that are wondering, and I just went after it. So this is something new, but I kind of like how it turned out. So I don't know how much you've sanded wood before, especially after it's been painted, but there's times where it's a workout, guys. Like, your arm gets tired depending on how sanded you want, which I like my stuff looking very chippy and old and worn and vintage, and so I usually do a lot of sanding, and sanding when things are dry is exhausting sometimes. So this was much easier. I mean, it immediately is coming off because, of course, the paint's still wet. And so you're coming off, you can see in the video, there's a little bit of like the paint, same as when you're sanding and it's dry. It kind of comes up in chunks and like bits because of course this was already painted black. So now it's sanding, it's pulling the black paint from underneath it up as well. And so you can always just sand it until those spots are gone. And then at the end, you can always go back and smooth it when it has dried. But to be honest, I didn't even do that. I just left it as is. And so you can see that when I'm sanding, it depends on your pressure. So if I, since mine is already, this piece of furniture was already painted black, if I sand really hard, I'm using a coarse grit sandpaper, which means it's going to tear it up, take the paint off quicker than a really fine sandpaper. So as I'm doing it, if I push hard and keep using the coarse sandpaper, it's going to go through the like aqua color paint I have, through the black, down to the raw wood. So that's up to you. If you want to go through both layers, if you're sanding something that's already been painted and this is a second color or a third color, just be conscientious that if you do it rough sanding, it's going to go through multiple layers of paint. But if you're wanting to sand, like for me, just that aqua color off and leave the black underneath, then I need to sand lighter, if that makes sense. So really with this, I could have done a finer grit of sandpaper. I'm just used to picking the coarse one because normally, like I said, I'm normally sanding dry paint and it takes the coarse and a lot of manpower or woman power to get through the paint. And so really with the wet paint, if I were to do it again, I'd probably start with a finer sandpaper and you really just don't need that much muscle behind it. It comes off really easily. And so for those of you that are completely new to painting furniture or sanding furniture, in my opinion, there's really no right or wrong way to do it. But starting out, if you're new to it, you can kind of see that I'm going over the edges. So like really, I don't try to like sand the really weird spots that are awkward to get to. But picture, if this is an old piece of furniture that has been around, it's been bumped into, it's been, you know, drug across places, it's been moved in trucks, I'm sanding the places that it would have the natural wear and tear, which is pretty much every corner that's like exposed. So all of the outer parts. So you could do like the little spindles that are on the upper part. You can do the inside of those too. But all that I mean is like all the flat surfaces, you can do some, but the flat surfaces, just like the flat part of the leg, is not going to have as much wear and tear as like the corner, the square corner part of the leg, if that makes sense. I hope I explained that well. But just think of normal wear and tear of your furniture and where furniture kind of gets dinged at the bottom. And that's what you're going for. If you want it to look real and vintage and used, you're just kind of exposing those parts that would be exposed if this really was a piece of aqua furniture from, you know, whatever decade, the 1930s that's made it all the way to here. This is what would be naturally exposed because of all the wear and tear and kids throwing stuff and it moving from house to house and all that. And so since we are wet sanding, the paint is going to get on the sandpaper much more than when you're doing dry sanding. Sometimes it happens when you do normal sanding and you kind of have to fold over to a new spot in your sandpaper, but you're probably going to have to do that a lot quicker and sooner when you're doing the wet sanding because now you're just getting wet spray paint on your sandpaper. So when it kind of cakes up and it stops sanding, because at that point, if it cakes up on the sandpaper and you're still sanding with it, well, now you're just putting the paint back on the spots that you're trying to sand, which is not helpful. So when you notice that, just fold over to a brand new spot of sandpaper and keep going. Okay guys, and since I'm incredibly impatient, I went ahead and sprayed the table with my clear matte sealer, like a polyurethane kind of spray paint, and went ahead and did that so that I would be completely done. So I'm telling you, I did not take breaks in this table. I taped the top off with the painter's tape. I spray painted it. I immediately went inside and got my sandpaper and sanded it wet. And then I immediately did a second coat with that clear matte finish to kind of just cover it all, to seal it, and that way it was done. I mainly did this for me because I sanded it. I don't know really how old the table is. I don't know the black paint that was on it. You always have a risk of like having lead in it and stuff. And that's why I wore a mask when I was sanding. But I went ahead and just put my clear coat on it. That way, if it goes in the girls' room, I can feel safe about it being in there and knowing that it's okay. Okay, so now all of the painting is officially done. We have sanded, we have painted, it's done. So I'm just gonna let it dry the time that it's supposed to dry. So I'm going to leave it for several hours. I did two coats very close together, closer than is recommended by the spray paint bottles. And so I want to make sure I give it the decent amount of time to dry that it needs. Okay, guys, I had every intention of coming and peeling this tape off after about 3 hours. But, you know, life got crazy and I'm homeschooling the girls right now. And so I ended up taking basically about 5 to 6 hours between when I left it to dry and peeling the tape off, just so that you know, in case some of you are wondering. So then you just peel the tape off. The tape did a really good job of keeping the paint off of the table like it was supposed to, and it came up really easily. Okay, so I am pulling up the last tiny little piece of tape, and voila, the table is done. So you guys, for a free table and spending maybe 20 minutes on painting and sanding, I think it's really cute. I had every intention of keeping this in my craft room, which is where it stayed for about a month, as like a little side table next to my cute bench. And then one of my daughters begged to use it as a nightstand in her room, and it matches her quilt. And so I said yes. And so the table is already being used nightly to put her water and her books on and stuff. And so this is a well-loved table. So you guys, I just love that. There's nothing better to me than taking somebody else's trash, making it new again and making it cute. And now it's something in our home that we love, that my daughter loves having in her room. And it costs next to nothing to make it over. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, please give it a big thumbs up and make sure you subscribe for more videos. Bye guys.